Welcome to Big Lee's Corner. I am just your average schmo who likes to collect wrestling figures and show them off, or show off NASCAR diecasts, show off mystery boxes, unboxing mystery boxes, or even eBay boxes. I also love to do these little mystery packets. Sometimes I might even be on the back porch chopping things up with an axe. But anyway, if you like this segment, please like and subscribe for more. So I'm late on this pro wrestling loot unboxing, but I was waiting for a day for the woman of the house not to be home. So today she's not home right now, so I thought I'd do this unboxing. Which, by the way, I already previously did unboxing, so that's why you're going to see some of the things like the Blue Demon mask first. You know, the Blue Demon mask was originally at the bottom of the box. It's on top of the box because I already opened it. Up next, a Michael Maltis interview. Sorry. Had too much Cobra. Just got through watching Flea Market, and Cobra and Flea Market go good together. The Natural One, Michael Maltis shoot interview. Which is kind of interesting, because I kind of knew Michael Maltis a bit from his as soon as I get my bloody facts right. I mean, why am I saying bloody? I'm not being Ian Noah sane right now. As soon as I get my goddamn facts straight about Michael Maltis, I remember him as the first guy that Kurgan drugged to the back with his claw. I also notice him as a named jobber that won a match. And this goddamn laptop's being a piece of shit right now. But enough about that. So yeah, I kind of know Michael Maltis. Now, before I get any dumber, let's see what we got here. World Champions, 8-time L Beer. Soda Green Earth. God's Green Earth, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I didn't realize this word said God's. That's why it said soda. Alright, let's see. World's Champions. So basically, it doesn't look like it represents a certain wrestler. Alright. An autograph 8x10 of the Ultimo Dragon. The Blue Demon biography. Something about... Yeah, Blue Demon biography. I'm too lazy to read all this. I might fuck up a lot. So if you could pause the video and you actually want to read what this says. And finally, the thing I look forward to. The exclusive trading card of Pro Wrestling Loot. This time featuring the Young Bucks, who are members of the Bullet Club. Which, by the way, TNA kind of made them turn out to be Hardy Boy wannabes. As the older brunette was going by Max, and the younger blonde was going by Jeremy. Which, by the way, you put two together, you kind of see those being rip-off names of Matt and Jeff. But these guys pretty much made a name for themselves in the Bullet Club. And maybe more than that, I don't know shit right now. Because like I said, I'm dumber than usual right now, so if you know the Bucks, good for you. If you don't, well, do some research, because I gotta. Anyway, that's all for this episode of Big Lee's Corner. I'll try to have a nice day. By the way, on another note, I plan on coming back to the wrestling business, filming some shows, work security for others. I just made my announcement tonight, even though that was the booze actually talking, but I'm actually going to go through with it. Living with a woman is kind of miserable for me sometimes, so I gotta get out of the house sometimes, even if she tags along. And just think, 4 years ago, I fallen for a woman that loves going to wrestling business, and that's kind of somewhat what driven me away. All right. For real, this time, I'll try to have a nice day.